The Reserve Bank has left interest rates on hold, but say an increase was discussed at their meeting in an attempt to bring inflation down. Let's go live to Today Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers. Andrea, good morning. There is still a chance of a further rate hike later this year.
Yeah, good morning, Brooke. It's the last thing borrowers want to hear. Not only has the Reserve Bank kept those rates on hold at 4.35%, but there's also talks that they could be hiked up yet again. What could prevent that? Well, it all rests on stubbornly high inflation. If Australia can rein it in to that target area of 2 to 3%. There was an uptick in April, up to 3.6%, but the governor says there is still a chance we could get it under control.
We still think we're on the narrow path, but it does appear to be getting a bit narrower. We need a lot to go our way if we're going to bring inflation back down.
Michelle Bullock also warned that big spending governments could further stoke inflation. Treasurer Jim Chalmers has hit back at that comment, insisting that his government is focusing on cost of living relief without further worsening inflation. Brooke.
Okay, thank you, Andrea.
Well, the RBA's decision to leave interest rates on hold has left thousands begging for relief as they struggle to make ends meet. One single dad forced to rent out his own bedroom on Airbnb in order to stay on top of his bills. Steve Whittington joins us now live from Melbourne. Steve, thanks so much for your time this morning. Were you hoping there might have been some relief from the RBA yesterday?
Well, none of the economists were predicting any drop in the rate, unfortunately, Sarah. So I guess I've become a bit numb to the prospect that the RBA doesn't seem to think that inflation is down in their target zone yet, and they're not prepared to take any risks, which is really disappointing, obviously.
I think what you described there, Steve, is absolutely right. People are feeling very numb at the moment, right? Because things are so dire. We're all looking for some relief somewhere. I guess for you, you've come to the decision now to start renting out one of your bedrooms. For you, is that a solution? Talk me through that decision.
Well, actually, it's the second solution I've come to, Sarah, because previously I tried, successfully renting out my daughter's bedroom on a long-term rental. Now, I have my children part-time, share with my ex, and I thought actually it would be better if we had a long-term person who we got to know, because my children come and go, and also from a safety aspect. But my daughter and her bedroom was the most convenient, I suppose. And that was just disruptive for her. So we've parted company with that lodger on good terms. And an Airbnb is a less disruptive solution for my family. It probably brings in gross about $800 a month. I've been doing it for 4 months now. It's far from ideal, as you can imagine.
Yeah.
There is significant disruption, but it does allow me not to rent out my bedroom when my kids are here. So from a safety aspect and just an assurance and whatever, that's preferable. And I just go and sleep in one of my kids' bedrooms for a couple of nights. It's certainly making a difference to me in terms of being able to pay the bills. Because, for example, even with that, before I got paid yesterday, over the weekend, I was at the Aldi checkout and $46 worth of groceries was declined. And that's the first time that's happened to me in my life. And that's pretty embarrassing for a full-time professional who works in a pretty well-paid profession.
This is the thing, though, Steve. That's nothing to be embarrassed about. But what more can you do? I mean, you're forced to innovate. You're working full-time. Michelle Bullock yesterday said at least people are working. Even when they are, it's still a struggle, right? So the RBA does need to get a sense of what people are actually experiencing out there. And it seems as though they're a little bit out of touch. But you know what? It's not just the RBA. I mean, all they can do is target mortgage holders. It's really a broader approach these days. We need more help for those who are struggling, doing all the right things and not receiving that help. What more can be done?
Era, that's where my frustration and numbness starts to turn to anger, because raising interest rates is supposed to change people's behaviour, right? Now, we know that only one-third of Australians actually have a mortgage. So that's the first thing, is you're inflicting an awful lot of pain. And we know housing prices are through the roof, so mortgages are high. You're inflicting an awful lot of pain on a third of the population.
Yeah,
imagine if a farmer was trying to corral sheep into a pen and only a third of the sheep were responsive to the sheepdog, you'd find a different way, right?
No, absolutely, Stephen. I think that's the point. They do need to find a different way. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really feeling for you. Appreciate your time.
The Reserve Bank has put borrowers on notice considering raising interest rates.
For more, let's bring in John Keogh, Economics Editor of the Australian Financial Review, in the studio
Johnny.
Today. Johnny, how are you doing? Now, the governor didn't hold back, did she? Her language was pretty strong.
Yeah, look, this was a really sobering assessment, I think, from Michelle Bullock yesterday, warning that the narrow path is getting narrower to a soft landing for the economy, and also that we need a lot to go our way to get inflation back to target. And so she's not mincing her words.
No, I thought it was fascinating yesterday watching. I'm a pretty boring guy. but just her use of language, and then Jim Chalmers obviously getting a little agitated about them climbing into the fiscal policy.
Yeah.
That whole battle is going to be fascinating. In the next 6 months.
Yeah, well, Jim Chalmers called a snap press conference 5 p.m. here yesterday in Sydney after the Reserve Bank press conference. The Reserve Bank statement actually said federal and state governments are actually adding to a bit of demand in the economy. We've seen not just with the federal government's budget, but Queensland, a big spending pre-election budget there, WA, Victoria, had the New South Wales budget yesterday. No direct handouts to households for New South Wales, but still more spending going into the economy. And so the Reserve Bank is very much on alert to that. And they're a little bit worried that inflation is stickier than hoped.
They have to be a little careful, don't they? I mean, if you go too hard, you put us in a recession.
That's right, and I think they're very conscious of that. I mean, Michelle Bullock said it's not a clear-cut case either way. It is a difficult position for the bank to be in it. They don't want to hike interest rates. They would be reluctant interest rate hikers. But really what it's all going to come down to, we've got an inflation print in late July, and that's really going to determine, I think, whether they raise interest rates again or not in August.
She's saying, Jim Chalmers said, don't tell me how to do my job and I won't tell her to do hers, but it's pretty passive-aggressive, I reckon.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of to-ing and fro-ing here. Look, they've generally got a fairly good, respectful relationship, I've got to say, but obviously Jim doesn't want to wear any of the pain that might come from further interest rate rises.
Well, there'd be pain.
Yeah, absolutely.
Brilliant. Thanks, John.
We're talking about cost of living. The RBA has left interest rates on hold but warned they'll do whatever necessary to bring down inflation. It was interesting viewing yesterday, Matt. The governor says big spending government budgets, both state and federal, could force her hand.
Well, she's just belled the cat. The governor of the Reserve Bank is just blowing up this government's budget. And she's done so in the best way she can. Obviously, she can't come out directly and say that. But clearly, the Reserve Bank is very frustrated at the fact that the federal and state governments are not helping them here bring down the cost of living. And that's what we've been saying about Labor's first two major budgets. They've been big spending budgets. And the Reserve Bank is now backing our analysis of that. And that's just the big spending amounts of this government is putting fuel on the fire of inflation that's raging through Australian households. And look, maybe it's time for another budget. Maybe after these comments, the Labor government should get their act together and put forward a mini-budget, which actually restores fiscal discipline and helps out. Well, this one's been a complete disaster, clearly. Every economist has panned
it. A lot of people are struggling out there.
Now the Reserve Bank of Governor, very unusual for the RBA governor to say something like this, has also panned it. Maybe we need a revision. Let's give Jim Chalmers a makeover and let him do the test again and do another budget.